This is the syntax for a ternary operator, where A is a conditional statement that evaluates either true or false. If the statement is true, then B is evaluated. If the statement is false, then C is evaluated. When the question mark character is used with a colon character separated with spaces, that's called a ternary operator. That's because this operator requires three operands, A, B, and C, unlike most other operators that only require two operands, like the addition operator. When using the ternary operator, using a space before and after is required around both the question mark character and the colon character. Using the ternary operator is another example of conditional evaluation. The behavior of the ternary operator is just like the if expression from the last chapter, only the syntax is very different. Let's take a look at an example. I'm in VS Code, and I've already created a new .jl file. And I've also launched the Julia REPL by using Alt-J, then Alt-O. Let's start by setting up the same three conditions and the same three tasks that we used in the last chapter. Evaluate the first condition only, and then evaluate the three tasks using Shift-Enter. Using the ternary operator will give you the same results as using an if expression, but you can get that result by using a single line of code. Now before hitting Shift-Enter, let's talk about this code. Starting on the left-hand side, x is greater than y is a conditional statement that will evaluate either true or false. If the conditional statement is true, then the code after the question mark is evaluated. If the conditional statement is false, then the code after the colon is evaluated. The ternary operator is meant to have only three operands, but you can include another ternary operator nested within a ternary operator by using a pair of parentheses. So that last expression is a nested ternary operator, which allows you to include another conditional expression. Even though the syntax is very different, behavior-wise, it's the same as using if, else, end. Now hit Shift-Enter to see what happens. In the REPL, you'll see 1 is less than 2, which is the same result that you got when using the if expression. Now let's go back up to the top of the code and swap the values between the variables x and y. Now rerun your ternary operator code to see what happens. In the REPL, you'll see 2 is greater than 1. So the ternary operator works. It performs a different task based on a different condition, just like an if expression. Now go back up to the top of the code and try the third condition. Now rerun your ternary operator code to see what happens. In the REPL, you'll see 1 is equal to 1. So the ternary operator worked again. It performed a third task based on a third condition. Pretty cool, right? Now, even though this is fun, as a beginner, you should learn to use the if expression until you're comfortable using it. The ternary operator is not available in all programming languages, but the if expression is commonly used in other languages. So it's worth spending the time to learn how to use the if expression first. But after gaining some experience, you can use the ternary operator as a shorthand form of the if expression for conditional evaluations in Julia. So that's the basics of using a ternary operator in Julia. In the next chapter, you'll learn what a while loop is and how to use it in Julia.